This is the plaintiff, Demary Rodriguez. She says the defendant is now her ex-boyfriend, who she has a 2-year-old with, and he co-signed a loan for her so she could get a Dodge Caravan because she has 5 kids to tote around. Then, out of the blue in August, the guy shows up saying if she doesn't give him the car, he was going to report it stolen because it's not in her name. Her car was towed off her property by the sheriff. She put down all the money on the car, and the spiteful defendant owes her $7,226.42 because now he has the car and she has nothing. This is the defendant, Angel Zalamar. He says the plaintiff is a vicious woman who isn't allowing him to see their 2-year-old baby, and he's brokenhearted over it. As far as the car goes, he put down the 10 grand on it with the dealer. He's paid the loan off in full with the bank, and how dare she play games with their daughter over this car? Oh, her? She owes him. He's accused of dissing an ex. The defendant has filed a countersuit for $8,000, the money he gave to the plaintiff to pay her bills while they were together.
All parties, please raise your right hand. People's Court is now in session. The Honorable Judge Marilyn Williams is now presiding. Litigants have been sworn, Your Honor.
Thank you, Douglas.
You're welcome.
Ms. Rodriguez, Mr. Zalamar is the father of what, your fifth child?
Yes.
How many children do you have? You have 5, and what? How old is the eldest?
The oldest one is 16.
Okay. The child that the two of you have is how old? 2 years old?
She's 2.
All right. Now, at some point in time, you folks buy a car. Tell me about that transaction. Who was supposed to pay what?
So the agreement between me and him was that I would trade in my car. I had my taxes, my tax return that came back. I was supposed to put the $5,000 towards the new car. So the trade-in plus the $5,000 that I was going to put down on the car, and he was going to take care of the financing, and I was responsible for the insurance on the car from the day, you know, I drove it off the lot.
And who was going to make the payments?
He said he was.
Okay, so what happens? What kind of car do you buy?
I chose a 2018 Dodge Grand Caravan.
Okay. Did you ever put $5,000 down?
At the dealership, no. But I did cash app the money to him, which in between those cash apps, they only show that I paid, I think it was $3,700. But I also have text messages from him stating why I only sent that money, because he told me not to send the full $100 because he was helping pay for the stuff in the house, which I also provided proof of that as well.
How long were you guys dating, by the way?
We were off and on for like 3 years.
Okay. And when did you break up?
We broke up twice. So the last time we broke up was in May.
All right. And why did you break up?
Well, he actually had came to visit after his surgery. And according to him, he just couldn't do it no more. He gave me back my house key and he left. He went back to Virginia. So he has his own reasons as to why he walked out.
Okay, and then how did it come to pass that he took the car from you? Because he ends up taking the Dodge Caravan, right?
After his surgery, they were going to release him from med hold in Virginia, and he needed a place to stay. At first, I told him it was okay for him to stay here, but then it was just a lot that went into the situation, and I ended up, well, in between there, he asked me if he could borrow the car. He was going to drive down here, take my car to Maryland, and then he was going to pick up his stuff and drive the car back. And I told him no, because that was my only form of transportation, and he wasn't on my insurance. He said, but I am on your title. And I said, well, what is that supposed to mean? Because you're on my title, you have the right to take the car whenever you want. When the agreement
was,
who's
on the title? Your understanding was who was on the title?
We both were. On the registration.
Both of you were
on
the
title.
And then, so he says, well, I am on the title, and then what?
And then he says, well, you can say no, it's not a problem. And I said, no, you're not on my insurance, you're not supposed to be driving, God forbid something happens, and then we're both screwed. So
at this point, are you guys dating or you're not dating?
No, we're not dating.
So how did he get his hands on the caravan? How did he get it?
I said to him, you can either give me the $5,000 that I put down on the car, or let me finish making the payments, because at that time, there was still probably about $2,000 left to pay on the car. And I told him, I could handle my own. Let me just finish making the payments. No, he didn't want to do it that way. In fact, I brought it up to him twice. He let 22 days pass without saying anything to me about the car or that he even had the intention of even picking up the car. If he would have had at least some sort of decency to be like, okay, well, this is my intention. I'm going to gather the $5,000 for you, make arrangements to get a new car, wouldn't be here right now. But
so what happened?
22 days pass. He let 22 days pass. He calls me. He texts me on my daughter's birthday, which was August 19th. Tells me he got the $5,000 for me. He's going to pick it up the next day around 7 or 8. Every Thursday, my daughter has physical therapy at 2 p.m. Every Thursday. That day, she didn't go to physical therapy because she had a doctor's appointment where she had to get her immunizations and her physical. He shows up at my house. He texts me and tells me, where are you? That he's at my place right now, that he's gonna, that he's here to pick up the van. I told him, no, you don't call me, you don't text me the day before telling me that you're gonna pick up a vehicle knowing it's my only form of transportation.
Okay, so now what happens? He takes the car and you come home and find the car missing? Tell me how the car ends up missing.
No, when he showed up that Thursday, the 20th, he tried to take the car, but the sheriff who showed up asked me to show them the paperwork and then told him her name's on the paperwork too, so I can't force her to give her a car, the car to you, because her name's on the paperwork. He let the whole weekend pass by. Monday, while I'm at work, he shows up, the sheriff knocks on the door with a tow truck, and they tow my car away. So I wasn't gonna make a big scene because that's just not who I am. So I
Right, but how was he able to get that sheriff to tow the car? If your name was on it, let me ask you, Mr. Zalamar, how is it that you were able to tow the car if both of your names are on the title?
Okay, so after she repeatedly was saying to give her back the money or making her finish making the payments, I decided not to respond and I did my due diligence. I spoke to Capital One and I also spoke to the DMV. So in the state of Florida, they went under what said on the title. So on the name of the title, it said my name or her name.
So or her that, name.
Yes. So they had told me that either or could go pick up the title, either or could take each other's person's name off the title. Since she was constantly telling me about giving her back her money, so I did everything and switched everything over, but it took time. Once
you
I had
did everything legally.
Over, yes, I switched the title.
Except for the part about giving her the $5,000. Where's the $5,000?
Well, it wasn't even $5,000 that she gave me. It was only $3,700.
No, she gave you $3,700, but according to her, you then gifted her the remaining $1,300 and told her not to pay it. That's true, right? That's a gift, a completed gift.
No, no, it wasn't.
What's the date of the text where he tells you about don't worry about the rest of the payment? Where is that?
It had to have been sometime in February or March. I'm actually scrolling through it, and I'm trying to find it as well.
When did you guys break up?
We broke up in May.
Yes. We broke up in May, and I was still trying to...
Why did you guys break up, Mr. Zalamar?
It was like nothing I ever did was ever good enough for her.
What do you mean nothing you ever did was good enough?
Well, I mean, I would help her with all her bills when I wasn't living there. I also gave her money for her other son, the bicycle that she wanted him to have so that way he could ride that to school instead of the bus. And it was like nothing. She didn't appreciate any of it. So I just got tired of it.
All right, Ms. Rodriguez, did you find the text where he says that he's forgiving the other $1,300? Where is that?
On 226. So it doesn't show the $600 because that was over the phone, but it does show the $700 that he did say not to send it because he was going to send it to me anyway. It says, hey, babe, subtract the $700.
Hey, babe, subtract $700 from the $2,200 because I was going to send you $700 on Friday anyway for the bills. So I see where you should get credit for another $700 because otherwise he wasn't sending you bill money. I get that. But where is the other $600?
The other $600, if you look up a little bit more, I asked him if he wanted me to just subtract the $600, but then he never responded by text message. He had called me and told me yes. So I don't know.
Okay,
really have
now there's a point in time later on when everything's hitting the fan where do you tell him by text if you come up with $5,000, you can just take my van?
I told him yes. I gave him the option of whether he can give me my
$5,000. And you acknowledge that that's exactly what the deal supposedly was. The problem is she feels like you didn't give her enough time. But then you take the van, you title it in your name, and you don't give her a penny. Why is that?
The van and everything like that was under her possession. The van, the key, everything. So after the first time that I had showed up to get the vehicle, I told her, I was like, hey, I'm here to pick up the van. And that's when she told me that I wasn't going to get the van. And I was like, please do not make me call the authorities and have me report it stolen. And she said, do what you got to do. And I was like, oh, okay. So that's when I called the authorities. They came by and they asked me the same question. How did you manage to get her name off the title? And I explained to them the same way that the DMV explained to me, because it had my name or her name. That was the only way that
not
it was allowed.
Not your name
to.
And her name, which is how it should have been. So I have a much more profound and fundamental question for you, Mr. Zalamar. This is the only transportation she has. She has five kids, one of whom is your daughter, who goes to physical therapy. Can you explain to me why you're taking the van away from her? Why are you doing it at all?
Well, yes, she does have five kids. Four lives with her. When I first tried to take the vehicle because she was constantly talking about giving her the $5,000 back, that means that she wasn't worried about that being her only transportation.
Yeah, but do you understand that if you just come up and with 24 hours notice, you say, I'm here for the van, that she doesn't have time to buy another car? You understand that, right? Your brain cells are connected.
Yes, I understand.
You understand that you're going to leave her and four children, including your own, with no means of going anywhere, including physical therapy. You know that, right? But your anger at her is so, so much more that you would rather be able to bring the... You turn around, you do these little shenanigans with the state and get her name off the title behind her back and then call the authorities and then tow it. It is more important to you to win on that because you're so angry at the way she treated you. But think about it. You know, you took the only method of transportation away. That doesn't seem to you like maybe a crappy thing to do?
I only did it because she asked for the money back. If she never asked for the money back.
She asked to have a deal with you that you all of a sudden, within a 24-hour period, said, I'm picking up the car. The way it went down makes it look like you're mad at her. What are you mad at her for? That she didn't love you the way you wanted to be loved?
Oh, no. No. Even though she took my daughter away from me.
That she wasn't grateful?
Even though she took my daughter away from me.
What do you mean she took your daughter away from me? What do you mean she took your daughter away from me?
I haven't seen my daughter since the first time I tried to take the vehicle. And she wants to say, because of the state of Florida, you don't have any proof that the baby is yours. You don't have the right to see her. I'm not allowing
it. I don't know what you're talking about. If she said that, she's a liar. And if anybody said that to me, that would never stop me from seeing my kid. All you have to do is file a paternity action, and you will be able to see your child. By the way, are you on the birth certificate?
Yes.
Yeah, then that's it. You're pretty much home free.
Oh, in the state of Florida.
But you have to
marry.
File.
That doesn't count.
That is ridiculous. It is not truthful. And you are an idiot for taking your legal advice from the woman you're fighting with. Don't you care about your child? Don't you want to fight for your child? Why don't you get a lawyer or go on your own to family court, because you can go on your own and sit down with the counselors there and file an action for paternity. That's all you got to do. Now you're going to have to pay child support, too. That's usually the reason I don't see that side fighting for their kid. But child support is not a cover charge for seeing your kid. You get to see your kid, okay? And so what if the court orders a paternity test? If it's your kid, it's your kid. You'd want to know that, right?
Yes.
Jeez Louise. All right. You have a counterclaim against her. What is your counterclaim? Go ahead, Mr. Zalamar.
It was for all the money that I gave her for the house bills, for her son's bike that I also helped out, and all the money that I had sent
during your relationship?
Throughout this whole entire time until June of this year.
So that's what you're doing. You are asking a court to order her to return any penny that you willingly gifted her during your relationship. Why would I do that?
Well, in terms of why, it's because not only with the whole issue with the baby, she also had told this to her own kids, which resulted in her son conversating with my daughter about the situation. And that's why I'm not allowed to see my daughter, because she chose that. So if she's not mine, and if I don't know that she's mine, why would I have helped her?
Why don't you put your big boy panties on and go find out if that's your baby and go fight for your baby? How's that for a plan? You can do that, okay? You can go to court.
Yes, ma'am.
It's just a lot of trouble, but you can go to court. So maybe you should go to court. But in the meantime, the fact that you're mad at her doesn't allow you to go back on the agreement that you had with her that you would only take the van if you gave her $5,000. You decided not to give her $5,000 when you know darn well that you took her name off, not because you bought the van from her because you hadn't paid Boo, but because you were trying to be vicious. That's why you took her name off of it.
I was not trying to be vicious, ma'am.
Yes, you are, because she's had to sue you for the $5,000. You never gave it, so she can't buy another car. So I'm ruling in favor of Ms. Rodriguez in the amount of her $5,000. This insurance money that you're suing for, why would he have to pay you back insurance money when that's insurance money that you paid for to drive the car the time that you drove it? He doesn't have to reimburse you for that. And on your counterclaim against her for $8,000, because I want all the money for travel while I was visiting my girlfriend for the past 2 years, are not compensable expenses. That's money you spent in a relationship. That's not a loan. So zero on your counterclaim, $5,000 for Ms. Rodriguez.
So the plaintiff is finally going to get her $5,000 back. She has a judgment against the defendant. Mr. Zalamar, what do you think about that? You're going to have to give her the $5,000 now.
Oh, that's fine. I was going to give it to her that day anyway. I still have the money for her.
What have you been waiting for?
I've been waiting for her to just be like, hey, can you just give me back the money?
You know, you never responded. Didn't you feel guilty at all about leaving her high and dry with four kids and no card?
I only did what she had asked me to do. That was it.
Well, bottom line, you owe her the $5,000. You're finally going to have to cough up and give it to her. Ms. Rodriguez, what are you thinking?
It's over. I'm happy. Couldn't ask
and
for nothing more.
It's his daughter. You say it's his daughter. He will have to have parental rights at some point. Are you going to let him have that?
I never took the rights away from his daughter. That day he came to pick up the van, he asked me if he could take her for the weekend, and I told him no. That was probably like the only time that I ever told him no to taking his daughter, and that's because we already had plans. Like I told him, the world does not revolve around him, and it's not everything at his time.
All right. Well, good luck to you. I hope things work out soon in your favor.
Thank you.
Let's see what the judges think now. Time for another session of After the Verdict.
I got to tell you, Marilyn, I'm having a real hard time understanding the thought processes that were going through this guy's mind when he goes to the mother of his child. She's got five kids, one of whom has to go to physical therapy every Thursday.
His kid.
And he takes the car by means that are deceptive, not exactly Grand Theft Auto, but he messes with the title. He has an agreement. He reneges on the agreement. I mean, my God, I would sooner ride a bicycle with two flat tires all over the county for a month or two then take that car away from someone in that situation.
Horrible.
Really, really. This,
yeah,
it's
he
just
doesn't get it either. He's so mad at her that he just, you know.
It just clouds his judgment, apparently. Yeah. And you also pointed out that the right thing to do if he's concerned about paternity establishing paternity, et cetera, he can bring a paternity suit in the state of Florida.
Of course.
I mean, his name is on the birth certificate. He's presumptively the father of this child.
Right.
Right?
So, correct. And so that's the presumption. That's how you walk in. And then if there's any question about it, the court orders a paternity test, and then that's it.
Okay, so George wrote in and asked this. Hey, Arvy, if my neighbor's tree roots grow onto my property underground and mess up my septic system, isn't my neighbor responsible to pay for the damages? Well, here's the thing about that. If the branches intrude like that and it does mess up your septic system, I think you do have a case. It's complicated, however, because you do have the ability to mitigate damages. That means you can minimize your damage by cutting the roots back to the property line. Now, this is dicey. You cannot go past the property line. If you do, you're in trouble. But if you cut the roots to the property line on your side of the property, you are allowed to do it. And hopefully, you can do it before the septic tank gets ruined. That will do it for this case. Litigants are inside the courtroom for the next case.